Hello, this is Michael Sulock, and in this video, we're going to be doing an example of exponential population growth. And I have a problem here that we're going to do, which is about the population of China. Let's just read this problem. In 1980, the population was 981 million people, and in 2016, that number grew to 1.38 billion. And we're trying to find an exponential function that represents this growth. And because it's an exponential function, the format that we're going to use is a, b to the t, where t is the number of years since 1980. So a big problem-solving strategy for me is to draw a picture. So since t is the number of years since 1980, in the year 1980, that's going to be zero. And then the next date that is important in this problem is 2016. And how many years is that from 1980? Well, that's 36 years later. So if we think about our population, in 1980, we have 981 million people. And then the next important landmark is what happened in 2016. And the population was 1.38 billion people. It's really important to use the same units. We could have used billions. We could have used millions. We could have just written out all the zeros for both these numbers. But I think it's easiest and most convenient just to use the population in millions for this problem. So what's happening is that the population of China is going up, and it's going up exponentially. So it's not like a line, it's a curve where it gets steeper. And so the first part of this problem is we need to find this equation, and that equation is going to be in exponential form. So that is our goal, is given these two data points, we want to figure out how much A is and how much B is. So the first thing that's important to remember is that the A in an exponential equation is the initial value. It's always the y-intercept. It's the starting amount. And so for this problem, since we're starting in the year 1980, our A is going to be the population in the year 1980. It's going to be 981. So that's a big help. Now we just need to solve for B here. And you could do this in your calculator, but I'm going to do it algebraically. I'm going to set up an equation. I've already used one data point that was given to me, which is the initial value. Now we're going to use the second piece of data that we have. When t is 36, the population is 1380. So all I'm doing is I'm plugging in this data point into my equation. So I need to solve this for b. So giving myself a little bit more room here to solve this for B, I'm going to divide both sides by 981. So in order to solve for B, I'm going to have to take the 36th root of both sides. And then if I round to five significant digits, I have solved for B. So now that we have B, we have actually finished with part A. We found an exponential function that models this population. So this is our exponential function that represents how the population of China is growing as a function of t, the number of years since 1980. So there's a second part to this problem, which is use your function to predict the population of China in 2030. What that means is that the time in the year 2030, which again is the number of years since 1980, is going to be 50, because 2030 is 50 years since 1980. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our function and we're going to plug in 50 for the time. So in a situation like this, you need to do the exponent first, And now lastly, I just need to multiply that by my starting amount and I get my answer. That is in millions of people. As a quick overview, what did we do? We remembered that the A in this exponential function is always the starting value. And then the B is what's sometimes called the growth factor. And we plugged in these two values into our equation to solve for B. And then once we had our equation, then we can use it to make predictions to figure out what we expect will happen for the population of China. There's a lot of people in China. It's a big country. I think problems like this are really interesting because they're using math to try to figure out what's going on with the world. So this is Michael Sulock, and I will see you next time.